dear students, how are you? I hope you will be in the best of your health and enjoying your life. Students, if you want to make maths easy for you, I suggest you quickly subscribe my channel and don't forget to press bell icon and select the option of all. Students, today we'll start 9th class math, exercise 2.4. The name of the chapter is Real and Complex Numbers. So, we'll start. In exercise 2.4, we have question number 1. Use laws of exponents to simplify. And its first part is 243 power minus 2. Its exponent is minus 2 over 3. And it is multiplying with a number 32 with exponent minus 1 over 5. Divided by radical sign with number 196 and its exponent is minus 1. So let's start. Students, first of all, you must understand the statement of the question. It is written, use laws of exponents to simplify. This is a complex number. It's a fraction or a number or a complex number, real and complex number. So we have to simplify but using laws of exponents. Let's see how to do this. First of all, see this number 243. We have to find its prime factors, or it would be easy if we get its perfect cube number. So let's do it. In the rough work, we'll find its factors, prime factors. 243, it is divisible by 3. 3 8s are 24 and 3 1s are 3. Again, it is divisible by 3. 3 2s are 6. From 8, 2 will be given away to the next number, which is 1. So that number would become 21. So 3 7s are 21. And again, it is divisible by 3. 3 9s are 27. 3 3s are 9. And 3 1s are 3. So by finding the factors of this number, we have got 3, 5 times 3. So here we can write, students, 3 with power 5, because we have found the prime factors. So they are 5 and the number is same, which is 3. So we can write its power of 3, or exponent of 3 would be 5. And its whole power or exponent is minus 2 over 3. Next number is 32. students, we can find its factors also. It is divisible by 2. 2 1s are 2, 2 6s are 12, 2 8s are 16, 2 4s are 8, 2 2s are 4 and 2 1s are 2. Again we have got 5 factors of the next number, which is 32, and the number which is coming or repeating is 2. So we can write 2 5 times. So we have got power of 2 or exponent of 2, 5, and the whole exponent is minus 1 over 5. Now it's turn to solve or to simplify the denominator, the number which is written in the denominator. It is 196. Let's find its prime factors. It is divisible by 2, which is the first prime number. 2 9s are 18. 1 will be given to the next number, given away. 2 8s are 16. And then again with 2, it is divisible by 2. 2 4s are 8. 1 is given to the next number. That will become 18. 2 9s are 18. Now 49, we know that it is only divisible by 7. 7 7s are 49 and 7 1s are 7. Now we have got all the prime numbers the same. It is 2 2 times, 7 2 times. So we'll write inside the radical sign. So in place of 196, we can write 2 square and multiplied by 7 square. All power is minus 1. So let's see. The radical sign of 3 is 5, and both the radical signs will be multiplied. 5 multiplied by minus 2 over 3 means powers will be multiplied. Now the same is here, radical sign of 2 or power of 2, 5, will be multiplied by the whole exponent, and in the denominator we can combine the powers of these two numbers, 2 and 7. It will become one whole power of 2 multiplied by 7, and that would be 2, and this minus 1 will be multiplied by it. So students, in the next step we'll solve these. As you can see, the numerator in these powers are same, so we can cancel them. It will not be cancelled. As we can see, there is no same number. In the next step, let's see what to do. We have to do the next steps on the other side. Okay, in the next step, students, let's go to the other side of the whiteboard. It is 3 power. It will become, powers will be multiplied by each other. 5 2s are 10, and the power of 3 will become minus 10 over 3, and power of 2 will become minus 1, and the denominator would become, let's see what it will become. This power square will be cancelled by the square root. So, students, we are left with 2 multiplied by 7 whole power minus 1. Radical sign is cancelled by the square of these two numbers. So here, students, we can separate these two. The numbers in the numerator will remain same. They will be written as it is. And these two will be separated by the power, by the exponent. 7 power minus 1. And we can see in the numerator and denominator, there are same numbers. So we can cancel them. Now we are left with 3 power minus 10 over 3 all divided by 7 power minus 1. Students, as we can see, both the numbers in the numerator and the denominator has the negative signs. So to make them positive, we'll turn this fraction upside down. Minus 7 will move in the numerator and the numerator will move to the denominator, and their powers or their exponents will become positive now. So here it is simplified, but a few steps are left still, so we need some space to solve this. Okay, students, in the next step, let's see, 7 power 1 will become 7, and in the denominator we have 10 over 3 as a power or as an exponent. So we can write it as 9 plus 1 over 3. We'll split 10 into two parts. 9 plus 1. Let me show you why we have done this. Students, will separate the powers on 3. 9 over 3 is separated and multiplied by 3 power 1 over 3 is separated. So we have separated this exponent or this power into 2, and 3 will be written 2 times, 7 as it is, and here we can cancel 3 and 9. 3, they will be cancelled by the same number 3. 3 ones are 3 and 3 3 is a 9. So the power of 3 in this number is 3, and in the next number we can write it as a cube root. This is how to write it as a cube root, and this power of 3 will become 3 times 3 is 27 into 3 with the cube root. So you can see behind the book the answer is the same. This is how to simplify by using laws of exponent. Students, I hope that you have understood it very well. Method, if you like the method of my teaching, do subscribe my channel and don't forget to press bell icon and select the option of all as well, so you can get all the notifications of my latest videos. So students, that's all for today. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, goodbye. Have a nice day.